U. Last year, SU XA0 was the budget phone to beat. Lenovo's stateside subsidiary, Motorola, put out an uncompromising budget phone that pleasantly surprised us with a camera that matched the performance of pricey flagships, a processor that crushed every task we threw its way, and a battery that lasted a full day without a recharge. But a lot changes in a year. Now, there's more mid-range competition than ever, especially from Chinese phone makers like ZTE and Huawei. Meeting expectations isn't good enough. Breaking through requires innovation and an exceptionally low price point. We tested the Moto G5 against the budget market's best to see how it measured up. If you happened upon a side-by-side picture of the G5 Plus and G4 Plus, you'd be hard-pressed to find similarities between them. Short of some holdover hardware, XA0 and signature Moto styling, the G5 Plus shares little in common with its predecessor. That's both XA0 good news and bad news. Take the G5 Plus's fingerprint sensor, for example. In contrast to the squarish, cufflink-shaped button on the G4 Plus, the new one is oblong, indented, and much easier to press. The earpiece is narrower than the one of the G4 Plus, and the G5 Plus's power and volume rocker are noticeably sturdier. The G5 Plus's removable cover is contoured and bordered at the edges, with a faux aluminum band that runs its XA0 length. The water-resistant cover is technically metal, but it felt more like a hard plastic and a little cheap. It's also exceptionally slippery, XA0 enough to have us longing for the grippy back cover on last year's model. We aren't fans of the gigantic camera that sticks out on the back either. Unlike the G4 Plus, which stuffed the rear sensor into an oval-shaped bulge near the phone's top edge, the G5 takes a page from Motorola's Moto Z Force. Housing its 12-megapixel snapper, XA0 inches, XA0A protruding circular eyesore, XA0 its pitch-black color scheme clashes loudly with the subdued gray of the G5's back cover, and looks out of place. Luckily, not everything is a step down. We're fans of the G5's 5.2-inch screen size, which affords a decent amount of real estate without sacrificing compactness. The front and back are pleasingly minimalist. Save a Moto logo beneath the earpiece and etched branding on the rear cover. The SIM card slot is more accessible, XA0 it's on the G5's top as opposed to behind the removable cover.